Hi, welcome. Today we are going to study steady state approximation. Now, for this we have to consider a general reaction in which our reactant A initially gives us intermediate which is called as I1. Then that intermediate gives us another intermediate which is called I2. And which on further reaction gives us product P. So Ka is the rate constant for the first reaction. K1 is the rate constant for the second reaction. And K2 is the rate constant for the third reaction. Now in this reaction, product formation, that is P, results from the formation and decay of two intermediate species I1 and I2. So I1 and I2 are formed and undergo decay and finally give this product P. Now the different rate expressions for this reaction are as follows. Now see, dA upon dt. So from this reaction we have to write different rate expressions. So first rate expression is dA upon dt is equal to minus Ka into concentration of A. Now see how it comes. Here in the first reaction, A undergo decay to form I1 and Ka is the rate constant. Now as A undergo decay, therefore here comes minus sign. So minus Ka into concentration of A. So this is first equation. Then second, dI1 upon dt, it is equal to Kaa minus K1 I1. Now see how it comes. See here I1 is formed from A. Therefore Ka into A minus K1 I1, because that I1 when gives I2, then rate constant is K1, therefore it is minus K1 I1. Then for I2, dI2 upon dt is equal to K1 I1 minus K2 I2. So again here the I2 is formed from I1, therefore here comes K1 I1 and that K2 is the rate constant for the next reaction, therefore minus K2 I2. Okay, and for product, that product P is formed from the I2, therefore it is K2 I2. So these four are the different rate expressions for this reaction. Now see, when we consider this reaction, it is observed that initially we have A, okay, which is at higher concentration. As reaction proceeds, the concentration of A start to decrease. Now after that, when A concentration of A start to decrease, the concentration of I1 will start to increase. Now after some time, when I1 is converted into I2, the concentration of I2 start to increase and concentration of I1 start to decrease. And finally, when I2 is converted into the product, at that time the concentration of P increases and concentration of I2 start to decrease. So I repeat again, the concentration of A start to decrease. At that time, the concentration of I1 initially increases, then decreases. When it decreases, there is increase in concentration of I2. Again, that concentration starts to decrease and there is increase in concentration of product. Now see, what is the conclusion from this? The concentration of I1 and I2 in above reaction changes very little with time. So if we see graph again, here time is plotted again, concentration, The change in concentration of I1 and I2 is very little with the time. So as time proceeds, there is a no major changes in the concentration of intermediates I1 and I2. Therefore, time derivative di upon dt of these concentrations can be set approximately equal to 0. That is, di1 upon dt is equal to 0, di2 upon dt is equal to 0. Therefore, overall, di upon dt is approximately equal to 0. So, this is known as steady state approximation. Now, why it is equal to 0? See, the concentration of I1 and I2 in a Bohr reaction changes very little with time. Therefore, the time derivative di upon dt of these concentrations can be set approximately equal to 0. Now, see the actual statement of steady state approximation or steady state principle. So, when a short-lived reaction intermediate exists at low concentration in a system, the rate of formation of intermediate can be considered to be equal to its rate of disappearance. The rate of formation of intermediate can be considered to be equal to its rate of disappearance, that is, both are equal to 0 finally. So, this is all about the steady state approximation or steady state principle. Thank you.